Desmond Tutu Legacy Foundation shuts down fake news of his death. The official handle of the Tutu Legacy Foundation has shut down claims making rounds that the famous Archbishop, Desmond Tutu, is dead. The fake news was first shared by a Twitter handle claiming to belong to Bishop Stephen Morio of Johannesburg, which did not share details of the supposed death, rather said they would release a statement shortly. It wasn't long before the Tutu Legacy tweeted a statement, shutting the story down. The Desmond and Leah Tutu Legacy Foundation can confirm that this is not true, it is fake news, the statement said, adding, "At the Desmond Tutu as well as Mrs. Leah Tutu are still with us. Thank you." Shortly after, the Bishop Morio account tweeted, "This account is hoax created by Italian journalist Tommaso De Benedetti. Desmond Tutu, in full Desmond Bello Tutu, born October 7, 1931, Klerksdorp, South Africa, South African Anglican cleric who in 1984 received the Nobel Prize for Peace for his role in the opposition to apartheid in South Africa. Tutu was born of Xhosa and Tswana parents and was educated in South African mission schools at which his father taught. Though he wanted a medical career, Tutu was unable to afford training and instead became a school teacher in 1955. He resigned his post in 1957. He then attended St. Peter's Theological College in Johannesburg and was ordained an Anglican priest in 1961. In 1962 he moved to London, where in 1966 he obtained an MA from King's College London. From 1972 to 1975 he served as an associate director for the World Council of Churches. He was appointed Dean of St. Mary's Cathedral in Johannesburg in 1975, the first black South African to hold that position. From 1976 to 1978 Tutu served as Bishop of Lesotho. In 1978 Tutu accepted an appointment as the General Secretary of the South African Council of Churches and became a leading spokesperson for the rights of black South Africans. During the 1980s he played an unrivaled role in drawing national and international attention to the iniquities of apartheid. He emphasized non-violent means of protest and encouraged the application of economic pressure by countries dealing with South Africa. The award of the 1984 Nobel Prize for Peace to Tutu sent a significant message to South African Pres. P.W. Botha's administration. In 1985, at the height of the township rebellions in South Africa, Tutu was installed as Johannesburg's first black Anglican bishop, and in 1986 he was elected the first black Archbishop of Cape Town, thus becoming the primate of South Africa's 1.6 million member Anglican Church. In 1988 Tutu took a position as Chancellor of the University of the Western Cape in Bellville, South Africa. During South Africa's moves toward democracy in the early 1990s, Tutu propagated the idea of South Africa as the Rainbow Nation, and he continued to comment on events with varying combinations of trenchancy and humor. In 1995 South African President Nelson Mandela appointed Tutu head of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, which investigated allegations of human rights abuses during the apartheid era. Truth and Reconciliation Commission, South Africa. Truth and Reconciliation Commission, South Africa. Members of South Africa's Truth and Reconciliation Commission, including Dr. Alex Sporane, second from left, Deputy Chair, Archbishop Desmond Tutu, Center, Chair, and Reverend Bongani Finka, right, Commissioner, at the Commission's first hearing, April 1996, East London, S.F. Benny Gould, Oryx Media, Desmond Tutu Peace Center. Get a Britannica premium subscription and gain access to exclusive content. Subscribe now. Tutu retired from the primacy in 1996 and became Archbishop Emeritus. In July 2010 he announced his intention to effectively withdraw from public life in October, though he said he would continue his work with the elders, a group of international leaders he co-founded in 2007 for the promotion of conflict resolution and problem-solving throughout the world. On October 7, 2010, his 79th birthday, He began his retirement. Tutu authored or co-authored numerous publications, including The Divine Intention, 1982, a collection of his lectures, Hope and Suffering, 1983, a collection of his sermons, No Future Without Forgiveness, 1999, a memoir from his time as head of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission, God Has a Dream, A Vision of Hope for Our Time, 2004, a collection of personal reflections, and Made for Goodness, and Why This Makes All the Difference, 2010, reflections on his beliefs about human nature. In addition to the Nobel Prize, Tutu received numerous honors, including the U.S. Presidential Medal of Freedom, 2009, an award from the Mo Ibrahim Foundation that recognized his lifelong commitment to speaking truth to power, 2012, and the Templeton Prize, 2013.